We can now speak to Hannah Herman. She's an advisor to President Yanukovych, and she joins me now on the line from Kiev. Hannah, thank you so much for joining us. We've just heard from Sweden's foreign minister there, who says Viktor Yanukovych has blood on his hands. There's been a lot of international criticism of the Yanukovych government. You know, what will it take for the president to back off?
Hello, thank you, and I'm going to give you the most recent news we received just now from the State Security Service. Head of State Security Service, and he's also head of the Anti-Terrorist Center of Ukraine, Mr. Yakimenko, he announced giving start to anti-terrorist operation in Kyiv. This is because the actions of the radical wing of the opposition, which now actually control Maidan, have all traits of terrorism. Among the proofs to this are arsons, murders, seizure of military divisions and security service premises in the regions, taking hostages and mass armament by the right-wing radical forces. Thus, in Ukraine today, a state upheaval by the right-wing radical forces is taking place. Within the last 24 hours, the radical forces got control over 1,500 units of firearms, 100,000 guns, and thus anti-terrorist operation is starting in Kyiv right now in this minute. Radical and extremist groups, by their actions, they carry real danger to the lives of millions of Ukrainians.
Well, most of the protesters, however, have been peaceful, and now 25 people are dead. As I said, EU leaders are putting a lot of pressure on the Yanukovych government, and they're accusing him of having blood on his hands. What's your reaction?
Within the last 24 hours, the situation has gone out of their control, of the control of the peaceful wing. Now the radical wing of the opposition is taking over. The right-wing radical forces are now actually in charge of the situation. Today they have attacked State Council of TV and Radio. The attackers are dictating their conditions even to journalists about what to cover. And the situation is getting very, very dangerous because the right-wing radical forces are attacking people, burning cars, seizing the administrative offices. And I'm afraid that less and less chances remain to a peaceful resolution of the situation.
Ms. Herman, if there can't be a peaceful resolution, what else is the response that the government will take with these protesters then?
The president calls to all forces, to the opposition, to the radicalists, to stop the conflict.
It's not just radicalists, though, Ms. Herman. There are a lot of peaceful protesters out there getting caught up in this violence.
The president calls to stopping violence, to stopping conflicts and renewing peaceful talks. He emphasized today in his morning appeal, which he made at 6 a.m. or this morning, that the only way to stopping conflict is renewing peaceful talks. However, those radicalists which are now controlling the situation on Maidan, they do not hear him, and the situation is getting out of control.
You say they want the president wants a peaceful resolution, but the protesters did attempt to peacefully resolve this. They were wanting the old constitution of 2004, but the president virtually ignored those calls.
Within the last 24 hours, the radicalists took over the peaceful protests, and now, for example, yesterday in the central streets of Kyiv, we saw burning of cars, we saw seizure of the administrative offices. The opposition does not want a peaceful resolution. They want only to seize the power with such radical and extremist ways, which is wrong, which does not lead to a peaceful resolution. That is why anti-terrorist operation is currently underway in Kyiv.
Ms. Herman, we're also hearing that Germany's Angela Merkel says that the EU will discuss sanctions on Ukraine. What's the response of the government there?
We believe that the West should not do such a biased assessment of the situation of Ukraine, because the situation is has gotten grave with the arsons and with murders and seizure of military divisions, seizure of security service, this mass armaments by the right-wing radical forces, they are taking place.
What is the tactic now? We're hearing reports that paratroopers have been called in. You know, will more people be killed on the streets of Kiev and around the country?
The anti-terrorist operation has started in Kiev just these minutes, and this is actually the last news we have on the situation.
There's also been accusations that Mr. Yanukovych changed his tune after meeting with Russia's President Putin, who advised him to crack down. What do you say to that?
I can only say that these are speculations.
Okay, Ms. Herman, we'll leave it there. Hannah Herman, their advisor to President Viktor Yanukovych.